Hi, I'm Michel Haesendonckx, part of the Global Solution Management Organization at SAP, responsible for the area of financial planning and analysis. In this video, I'll walk you through the business reasons and the ledger approach that universal parallel accounting is based upon. This was first introduced with SAP S/4HANA Cloud 2105 and now also becomes available with the latest S/4HANA release. The architectural approach we have decided to take with universal parallel accounting significantly impacts the way we deal with multiple valuation principles across the record, report, and FP&A process. Let's get to the business reasons why the universal parallel accounting approach has been introduced. First of all, international companies need to follow parallel accounting standards for group and local GAAP, affecting inventory valuation, work in progress, asset valuation, and so on. In addition, companies operating in certain countries require a fiscal year variant for their local financial reporting, which is deviating from their fiscal year variant for their central reporting on group level. In internationally operating companies, financial and management reporting needs to be available in several currencies, including beyond local and group currency, additional currencies such as functional currency. And last but not least, for business steering purposes, internationally operating organizations require a group view where intercompany profits between trading partners are eliminated in real time, also sometimes referred to as group valuation. On top, in some cases, a business unit view might be required where transfers to another business unit is treated as an external sale. Another business requirement, which is currently not covered, is the need for some organizations to add an additional operating division view where intercompany profits are eliminated within the operating view, but transfer to other operating divisions are treated as an external sale. When putting this in the context of the continuous globalization of supply chains, makes the topic even more crucial from a management accounting perspective. How can we optimize where we source, produce, and sell as cost-effective as possible to maximize our financial performance? How can we get the necessary insights in the impact of tax on our value chain? To answer these types of questions, an end-to-end financial view on all connected steps in the supply chain, or rather value chain, is required. Ledgers are used to distinguish the approaches. As a base example, one ledger captures financial information according to a common accounting principle so that the same approach is used to value assets and inventory, recognize revenue, and so on. A second ledger captures financial information in accordance with the various local or industry-specific reporting requirements. The ledgers determine which currencies are used. All journal entries include a global currency and a local currency, and further currencies, up to 8 additional ones in SAP S/4HANA on-premise to be precise, may be added as required. On top, the ledgers control the calendar used as well. This design principle in itself is not entirely new. But historically, however, there were limitations with carrying multiple valuations through the entire financial process in a unified way, especially from the management accounting perspective. Business transactions of affiliated companies include intercompany markups in the leading GAAP. In reality, these are often eliminated in a separate, often spreadsheet-based process. With universal parallel accounting, some steps can take place within the operational accounting environment in real time, with the valuation views handled as ledgers. Imagine the following situation. An investment project which consumes materials, activities, and other direct costs. When the investment project is finalized, it gets capitalized as an asset under construction, and in the end, as a finished asset. Depreciation kicks in, which ends up in a specific area of responsibility, typically represented by a cost center, whereby asset capitalization values differ between GAAPs. Depending on the situation, the cost on this cost center gets allocated. Up till here, handling multiple valuation views is covered, apart from the project settlement, which is based on the group valuation principle. Continuing our example, consuming these costs as activity allocation in a production process inventory valuation upon completion of the production process, and the analysis by different market segments when sold are only tracked by the group accounting principle. Mind you, this does not mean that multiple valuations cannot be tracked, but it's not done in a harmonized way and not in real time. As a result, the parallel valuation of assets, inventory items, and so on are not connected end to end. With universal parallel accounting in SAP S/4HANA Cloud, we establish a parallel value flow across the end-to-end process. Looking back at the exact same process example, this results in the elimination of the breakpoint we saw before when my asset was getting consumed in my production process. By introducing the ledger as the single harmonized way to handle parallel valuations end-to-end, a universal solution for general ledger and all subledgers resulting in a fully aligned financial and management accounting is provided, including currency management. The same principle applies when getting into more complex situations, like when applying actual costing. For the business user, this becomes really tangible when looking at how we report on assets, inventory, costs, and my overall bottom line. Switching between different valuation principles is done by selecting the appropriate ledger. As you can see, this way companies can easily follow parallel accounting standards for group and local GAAP affecting inventory valuation, work in progress, asset values, and so on. As mentioned, the business requirement coming on top of this from an unconsolidated level is to also bring the possibility to have this parallel valuation insight on consolidated level. As for steering purposes, customers require a group view where intercompany profits between trading partners are eliminated in real time to deliver management insights on group level during the period. To make clear how this works in view of both legal and managerial considerations, let's have a look at a ledger overview. Applying the ledger concept allows to have a local view next to the group view following the unconsolidated group GAAP valuation principle, and by applying the group reporting solution with SAP S/4HANA, also the consolidated view after having executed the consolidation process. An additional remark to make here is that the consolidation relevant master data elements, like the consolidation unit, which the consolidation process is based upon, are now part of the legal group GAAP ledger, allowing for real-time consolidation without the need for additional activities triggering data movements. Through the introduction of an additional ledger, we are extending the group view in two different alternative ways. While already possible in the on-premise deployment of SAP S/4HANA in the past, as for S/4HANA Cloud, this allows for an additional parallel group accounting view covering parallel gaps. An example where this would be interesting is in case a European corporate reporting in IFRS would like to add a US GAAP view for their Americas division. Secondly, such an additional ledger can be set up as a pre-consolidation ledger, aiming at providing a group view, as intercompany profits between trading partners are eliminated in real time. This includes the intercompany elimination at cost coming straight from the transactional postings. Original postings and elimination postings for internal revenue and cost of goods sold are stored in this additional ledger. This end-to-end way of dealing with parallel valuation on group level is a key baseline for bringing the concept of value chain analysis to reality. In case you'd like to learn more about this, please have a look at a dedicated video on this concept. Universal Parallel Accounting initially was launched with SAP S/4HANA Cloud 2105, but is now overall available in all deployment models of SAP S/4HANA. Currently targeting new implementations only, whereby some restrictions in scope currently still apply. To conclude, let me emphasize that this universal parallel accounting is the baseline not only for value chain analysis, but also other innovations like intelligent asset accounting, delivered together with universal parallel accounting in the cloud already today. Thank you for your attention, and definitely let us know in case you'd like to discuss this further.